Passing of Steve Jobs may leave lots of people thinking about all the gizmos the Apple founder created. iPhones, iPads, and iPods. But tonight his death leaves a creative void in the world's biggest entertainment company, Disney. WESH's Greg Fox is live in Seminole right now with perspective from the founder of the Disney blog. Greg?
Yeah, John Frost has been following the career of Steve Jobs since before he sold his Pixar animation studios to Disney for $7 billion. And John's been writing about it on his blog today and getting a lot of comments back. He works for a company also called Mind Comet that's in Altamont Springs, Seminole County. And this company might not even be around had it not been for Steve Jobs. It's the young Steve Jobs John Frost will remember most. The founder and owner of the Disney blog tells me the Apple founder was to the computer age what Walt Disney was to the motion picture age. Both became stars by two different kinds of mouse.
Well, they were both great innovators. Walt Disney invented the animation table, the multiplane camera, and really you could say he invented the theme park as we know it today.
The Disney blog and others have been working overtime to handle the comments on Jobs' passing. Quote, this brings tears to me, and Steve was one of the best.
Come to Papa!
His marriage to Disney and eventual role as board member and top stockholder began when he bought Pixar, maker of Toy Story and other computer-generated movies, from producer George Lucas, who believed it was doomed to fail.
Paid $5 million to buy a Pixar from Lucasfilm, and then less than 20 years later sold it for $7 billion to the Walt Disney Company.
Disney wisely let Jobs infuse new ideas into branding, merchandise, and mass marketing the Disney and Pixar name.
I definitely think you'll continue to see the influence of Steve Jobs even though he's not here anymore.
To steal the best marketing line Jobs ever delivered with the Macintosh debut, he will be remembered as, quote, insanely great. And on his own statement today, Bob Iger, the CEO and president of Walt Disney Company, his statement on Steve Jobs was quite simple. Jobs was an original. Jobs was an icon who defined a generation and a new culture. Live in Altamont Springs, Seminole County, Greg Fox, WESH 2 News.